Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Kaz Harai.
Welcome, and thank you for joining us for Sony Computer Entertainment's 2006 E3 press conference. And please accept my apologies for the delay in beginning this afternoon. Well, just one year ago, we stood before you, our industry friends and partners, and unveiled our plans for PlayStation 3 for the very first time. And the impact was immediate. We sent a message, and the message was clear. PlayStation 3 is not an incremental upgrade to our previous platforms, but is truly designed to advance our vision for computer entertainment today and for many more years to come. PlayStation 3 is a very powerful machine, yes, but technology is just an enabler. In essence, the real power of PlayStation 3 rests in the hands of the content creators and ultimately with the consumers. And let's face it, we aren't easily entertained these days. We want freedom, we want choice, we want to share experiences with others, but most importantly, we want to be entertained in new and unique ways. PlayStation 3 is meant to be the companion device in your living room, flexible enough to sustain many years of technological advancements. It's an arsenal of media compatibility with seamless access to both packaged and non-packaged content through a networked environment. It seamlessly interacts with the PlayStation family of products, such as PlayStation Portable. And finally, PlayStation 3 is the best of breed computer entertainment platform. And make no mistake, PlayStation 3 is the most ambitious project we at Sony Computer Entertainment have ever undertaken in our very short history. It requires huge financial investment and commitment from the entire Sony group. But we must take risks to reap the rewards. And we're not about cutting corners to rush a product to market, and we're certainly not interested in gimmicks, clever rhetoric, or conventional thinking. The essence of the PlayStation DNA is real change, and the consumers are ready. And we have said on many occasions that the next generation doesn't start until we say it does. And today, PlayStation 3 is real. The future becomes reality. As we gear up for the November launch, we're very excited to share with you the phenomenal progress we've made in just a year's time. But before I go any further, I'd like to take a step back for a moment. We're all well aware that we would not be able to achieve greatness on PlayStation 3 without a strong foundation, and one of the foundations for us is PlayStation 2. Initially launched in March of 2000 in Japan, PlayStation 2 has grown into a global format, and the install base continues to grow in all markets worldwide. Most recently, we were very pleased to achieve the 100 million unit shipment milestone on PlayStation 2 in almost half the time it took us to get there on the original PlayStation. And more specifically, our global shipments break down to 23.27 million in Japan and Asia, 41.82 million in North America, and 38.6 million in the European and PAL markets, with a global total of 103.69 million units. And for our current fiscal year that began on April 1st, we forecast shipping an additional 10 million PlayStation 2 units into the global market. On the software front, the numbers are just as impressive. We have shipped over a billion units of PlayStation 2 software worldwide. That's 1 billion units on PlayStation 2 alone in 6 years' time. And this is a major achievement for our industry, and for this, I would like to personally extend my thanks and our thanks and gratitude to all of our development, publishing, and retail partners here in the audience and around the globe for being a part of this phenomenal success story. In the 4 years since PlayStation 2 went online in North America, we have amassed more than 3 million registered users, all enjoying this generation's crown achievement, the essence of multiplayer and cooperative play in a networked environment. And now, you may ask yourself why we continue to belabor these points, especially when it's common knowledge that month after month, PlayStation 2 outsells all competitive formats. And the answer is quite simple. We want to remind everyone that PlayStation 2 has and will continue to make significant contributions to the industry and that Sony Computer Entertainment will be supporting the PlayStation 2 both on the hardware and software sides of the business for many, many more years to come, as we did on the PlayStation for more than 10 years. And we have an amazing lineup of PlayStation 2 titles to show at our booth, like the long-awaited sequel to God of War, SOCOM US Navy SEALs Combined Assault, Guitar Hero 2 from Red Octane, Yakuza from Sega, and many, many more. So please remember to check them out when you visit our booth. And outside of E3, consumers can look forward to 216 new PlayStation 2 titles from both first and third-party companies by year-end. Now, let me spend a little time on PlayStation Portable, the PSP. When we entered the portable space with PlayStation Portable, I often received two questions. Why did you wait so long, and why now? And these are two separate questions with one single answer. It's about the ability to offer the right product strategy at the right time. And for us, any product carrying the PlayStation brand has a lot to live up to. And yet again, we delivered on the promise. PSP is an unrivaled portable entertainment device, the culmination of the best that Sony has to offer. And at its core, PSP delivers unsurpassed gaming experiences in a portable system rivaling that of PlayStation 2. But knowing consumers' insatiable appetite for entertainment, anywhere, anytime, on the go, PSP also functions as a portable audio and video player through multiple delivery mediums like UMD packaged media or digital delivery online directly onto the memory stick. Just 18 months young, PSP is the fastest selling platform in our company's history. To date, we have shipped more than 17 million units worldwide. And that's almost 1 million units for each month of its life. And of course, there are no signs of slowing down. For our current fiscal year that began on April 1st, we forecast shipping an additional 12 million PlayStation Portable units into the global market. Software sales for the PSP have been just as impressive. We are closing in on 50 million units shipped worldwide with 545 PSP games on the market to date. And since its introduction, PSP has enjoyed wide support from both our first and third-party development community, and we estimate that another 155 titles will be added to its ever-expanding game library. So, let's take a look at some of the PSP titles that are scheduled for release later on in the year. PlayStation Portable, ladies and gentlemen. Now, one of the new and innovative ways we've provided opportunities for publishers and retailers to expand the software market on both the PlayStation and the PlayStation 2 formats was the introduction of the Greatest Hits program. And we certainly wish to extend these business opportunities and the consumer value that the Greatest Hits brings to the PlayStation Portable as well. So I'm pleased to announce today that we will introduce a PSP Greatest Hits program in North America, starting with five titles from Sony Computer Entertainment America: ATB Off-Road Fury Blazing Trails, Ape Escape on the Loose, Hot Shots Golf Open Tee, Twisted Metal Head-On, and Wipeout Pure. And to qualify for Greatest Hits status, a title must have sold 250,000 or more units and have been on the market for at least 9 months. PSP uses an optical disc medium called the Universal Media Disc, or UMD. In addition to game titles, PSP users also have a wide variety of movies, TVs, and other non-game content to choose from. And to date, in the US alone, more than 670 non-game UMD titles have been produced, and more than 18 million units shipped to market. And 23 UMD video titles have sold more than 100,000 copies. In addition to packaged media, PSP supports various communication functions. Additionally, through firmware upgrades, we have been able to add functionality to the PSP. And since we began firmware upgrades last May, PSP now has a web browser and features designed to enhance video, audio, and of course image usage, as well as improved content protection and network security. In the most recent update, 2.7, that launched at the end of April, added two great new features: the RSS channel and Macromedia Flash support. So now, consumers can stream or download the latest syndicated programming, MP3 playlists, or podcasts, and save them directly onto their memory stick. And later in the year, we plan to add RSS video, voice over IP functionality, along with camera and GPS peripherals. PSP is the whole package, an exceptional portable entertainment device. With games, movies, music, photo, and communication, it truly takes advantage of the consumer lifestyle trends. And in fact, we hope that you brought your PSP with you today, because after the event, we've set up a number of download stations that include game shares and assets from today's presentation, including an RSS feed of this very press conference. So please stick around and enjoy.
My name is Sean LeGrand.
Charles.
Tiffany.
Billy Morgan.
Kevin Cantrell.
And my name's Brett.
I'm out here enjoying Town Square.
Town Square, yeah.
Center of the universe.
So I lost some PlayStation.
I've been playing PlayStation for about
10 years plus.
The PlayStation 1, I thought it was the coolest thing because it played CDs.
Where the discs were blue and stuff.
The old system.
What I love about the PlayStation is the feel of the controller in my hands. I like the hard plastic and the little knobby bits.
I'm eagerly awaiting the PlayStation 3.
Third one, yeah, definitely waiting for that.
I've been waiting forever.
Well, I heard that the graphics on it was crazy.
It puts you into the story.
Like you are that character.
Like you right there.
Which is the best part of video games.
My name is Mairead.
My name is Mycroft.
Mark Hicks.
My name is Liam.
My name's Ams.
My name's Dana.
My name is Meredith Morrell.
My son is the best gamer I've ever played against. He's so fiercely competitive and he can never lose. And of course, being his dad, I have to let him win sometimes, because he doesn't beat me, obviously.
Hi, I'm Brittany.
Hi, my name's Dave.
Hi, I'm Lisa.
Warren, I'm living in Sydney.
Sydney. Sydney, Australia.
I'm looking forward to PlayStation 3.
Looking forward to all the new games coming out.
The high definition.
Blu-ray discs.
Internal hard drive.
I'm getting excited.
My name is Dylan.
Nicholas Daniels.
Jason Bettini is BB.
I live in Cape Town.
The coolest city in the world.
Technology. Wireless.
Wireless. Definitely the wireless controls.
I'm gonna walk around the house playing.
The thing is huge. I just can't wait for it to come out.
PS3の楽しみは2もすごかったんですけど、もっとどういうふうに映像が変わっていくのかっていうのを。そうですね。僕をはじめ
世界中の人たちの人生の一部にもっともっと住んでいくと思います。私はゲームするときにモンキー、サル。
Mi nombre es Daniel.
Me llamo Santiago.
Vivo en México.
Tiene muchas gráficas padres y tiene juegos impresionantes.
Me gustan la variedad de juegos, que si quiero deportes, tengo deportes. Si quiero acción, tengo acción.
The whole of Earth could be in a game.
Come on.
I'm gonna beat you, and it's gonna hurt, because I don't know.
Because I'm gonna rock on it, and I'm gonna have it first.
And I'm just looking forward to that experience, and I know that it's gonna come from PS3.
PlayStation 3 is the future of gaming.
Exactly, it's gonna be like taking over the whole world.
You know, we often talk about the global impact of the PlayStation business. And as the global leader, our mission at Sony Computer Entertainment is to create products that truly inspire and entertain fans around the world. And it's really amazing to witness such enthusiasm for our new platform. So, now on to PlayStation 3. Last year, we outlined the specifications of the machine, but let's review its main features and benefits. First, PlayStation 3 is powered by Cell. Along with our partners IBM and Toshiba, we have invested billions of dollars and hundreds of thousands of man hours in creating the Cell processor. It's a processor with power rivaling that of supercomputers, but is uniquely designed to support massive data processing required for digital entertainment and other HD-intensive applications. PlayStation utilizes Blu-ray as one of its storage mediums, but is also compatible with a huge variety of optical disc media used in consumers' homes today. And that the investment that consumers have made in collecting their software libraries in a variety of optical disc formats will not go to waste with PlayStation 3. And speaking of delivery mediums, we have already seen a diversification in the methods of delivering entertainment content to the consumers, which will become even more prominent in the years ahead. And to this end, PlayStation 3 is equipped with both a gigabit Ethernet port as well as a removable hard disk drive to allow the consumers to access and download a variety of interactive and other entertainment content right out of the network. And on the output side, as previously announced, PlayStation 3 will support true high-definition output at 1080p resolution and is compatible with the latest Dolby Digital surround sound for maximum audio enjoyment. So, what does all this mean? Simply put, we are giving the content creators unprecedented power to express their creativity and for the consumers to emotionally connect with and to enjoy the content that is created with a level of interaction, sophistication, and reality that has never been experienced with any other platform. Another first brought by PlayStation is back catalog compatibility. When we introduced PlayStation 2 in 2000, it supported many formats: PlayStation games, PlayStation 2 games, audio CDs, and DVD video playback. With PlayStation 3, we are taking it to the next level. Not only will PlayStation 3 support Blu-ray video and PlayStation 3 games, but also all of the formats that I just mentioned. PSP also interacts with the PlayStation 3, and on the game development side, we're aggressively seeking out ways to connect the two products in unique and interesting ways. Users can exchange data between the two systems wirelessly, through the USB connection, or through the memory stick. And as I mentioned, Blu-ray, it is a next generation format supported by major hardware manufacturers and motion picture studios. Five of the six studios that represent 80% of all Hollywood content are backing Blu-ray. Blu-ray offers the storage capacity that game creators require in order to manage data-intensive material needed to achieve real-time gameplay mechanics in a true 1080p HD world. Truly lifelike games, like those that we are starting to see, require considerable disk capacity. And content creators and consumers have told us time and time again of their desire for more. More gameplay levels, more sound, more intense graphics, more entertainment. And as a testament to the ever-growing need for storage capacity in our industry, consider this fact. During the first year after the PlayStation 2 launch, 74% of PlayStation 2 games were on the CD-ROM format, 26% in DVD. 5 years later in 2005, that ratio is 95% DVD and 5% CD-ROM. So by adopting Blu-ray, a forward-reaching medium, we're sending a message to the content creation community that the only limitation they have bringing ideas to life now is their imagination. And true HD gaming is the wave of the future. And according to our internal research, PlayStation users are more likely to own or plan to buy an HD display. And by the end of 2006, according to Jupiter Media Research, 25% of US households will own an HD display. In an HD world, complex data streams processing and massive storage is necessary. And therefore, we believe that PlayStation 3 will be at a significant advantage by having a hard disk drive built right into the box. That's right, every PlayStation 3 system will ship with a hard disk drive. Not only will users be able to download content from the network and other storage devices, but the HDD can serve to work to improve game performance and the overall entertainment experience through game saves and caching for optimal load times. And as previously announced in March, we're set to launch the PlayStation 3 simultaneously throughout the world in major territories this November. And to give you a glimpse of what the consumers can expect, this is the PlayStation 3, right here, in clear black, which will be introduced in all territories at launch. Our development partners have been diligently working on the PlayStation 3 environment for some time in order to deliver the type of gaming experiences that consumers will expect from true next generation. And to date, we have cumulatively shipped more than 10,000 development systems to 208 companies in 11 countries, the largest number ever for a PlayStation format. And final development systems are shipping now 6 months before launch, which is a first. In fact, some of the games you will see at E3 on the show floor are running on those final tools. And I'm very excited to report that both our internal studios and our third-party partners are prepared to share the fruits of their labor today. Contrary to what you may have heard coming into E3, today we will be showcasing playable game titles, which all will be available for you to play and enjoy at our booth. Back in the fall of last year, Sony Computer Entertainment consolidated its global development resources under one umbrella, the SCE Worldwide Studios. This consolidation allows us to further integrate all of our product development creativity, expertise, and technology on a worldwide basis, helping to develop exclusive, one-of-a-kind gaming experiences that define the PlayStation experience. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the president of SCE Worldwide Studios, Phil Harrison.
Thanks very much, Kaz.
Hey, Phil.
See you later. Good afternoon, everybody. It's a great pleasure to be back here. A little under a year ago, we shared with you and with the world our vision and technology for the PlayStation 3 format. In the last 350-odd days, about 8,500 hours, our development teams all around the world, in all of our studios, have been hard at work converting that technology and vision into magic. And today, I'm really proud that we will be able to share with you the fruits of those labors with a number of really incredible games played and shown on PlayStation 3 for absolutely the first time. I'd like to start by bringing onto the stage a creator who normally needs no introduction, but on this particular occasion, I think I will make one for him. I know him as my friend and colleague from Sony Computer Entertainment Worldwide Studios, and also as the creator of one of my favorite PlayStation 1 games, Motor Toon Grand Prix. You probably know him for his slightly more famous franchise, the billion-dollar franchise that is Gran Turismo. So please join me in welcoming to the stage Mr. Kazunori Yamauchi, and to translate, Tsubasa Inaba.
Thank you, Phil.
皆さんこんにちは、山内です。今日はですね、この E3 のために、グランツーリスモの、最新のプロトタイプを、持ってきました。題して、グランツーリスモ HD です。
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Kazunori Yamauchi, creator of Gran Turismo. It's an honor to be here as the lead-off batter for software titles this afternoon. Today, we would like to show you a Gran Turismo prototype that has been designed specifically for E3, Gran Turismo HD.
ちょっと説明しますね。このグランツーリスモ HD はですね、GT4 をベースに、データを高解像度化、高精度化して、プレイステーション3に移植したものです。
So just to give you some background, Gran Turismo HD, basically what it is assets from GT4 boosted in quality and resolution converted to PS3 platform. The milestone for future production for GT.
スクリーンを見れば分かる通りですね、このグランツーリスモ HD は 1920×1080 プログレッシブかつ60フレームで動いています。
The screen is quite self-explanatory, but the Gran Turismo HD will move at 1920x1080p at 60 frames per second.
1920×1080p のですね、非圧縮のベースバンド信号が家庭用のテレビに映るというのはですね、ちょっと大げさに言うと、人類にとって初めての経験だろうと思います。
So this may be an exaggerated statement, but we feel that this is probably the first time for a household television to display a non-compressed baseband signal.
はい、メニューもですね、HD に合わせてデザインし直しました。
So the menus have been designed specifically to optimize for HD resolution.
この E3 バージョンでは4つのコースが選べます。
You can select from a range of four tracks.
選択できる乗り物もですね、レーシングカー、クラシックカーから、モーターバイク、スクーターまで様々です。
In terms of vehicle selection, players will be able to choose from a range of vehicles from racing to commercial, all the way down to scooters.
じゃあ早速、東京のコースから行きましょう。
So first we'd like to demo the Tokyo track.
このですね、1920×1080、60p という、情報量がどれくらいかということをお話ししたいんですけれども、例えばですね、皆さんが普段見ているハイビジョンの放送ですね、HD カムで捉えています。だいたい HD カムの情報に比べて、今ここに映っている、情報はですね、3倍ぐらいの情報量が出ています。
So just to give you a reference point, What you're seeing on the screen now is 1920x1080p HD, full HD. Just for reference, the average broadcast HD that you would see in the household now, this is roughly three times the amount of information that is shown on the screen in comparison to that average broadcast HD.
プレイステーション2の GT4 と比較するとですね、約12倍ということになります。
Extending that example to GT4 played on PlayStation 2, the difference is 12 times.
それでは次のコースに行きます。
So let's next we would like to show you another track.
ですね、ローディング時間の短さにも皆さん注目してください。
Please pay special attention to the loading times here.
GT4 ではですね、大体平均して、15秒のローディング時間がかかっていました。
In GT4, the average loading time was roughly 10 to 15 seconds.
この PS3 版では当然ハードディスクにオプティマイズされていますから、ローディング時間が早くなっています。
For Gran Turismo HD, it has been optimized for obvious reasons to the hard disk drive that is equipped in the PlayStation 3.
だいたいそうですね、2、3秒で、ローディング終わるんじゃないでしょうか。
So players will probably be able to maneuver from the menu screen all the way to starting a race in a matter of 2 or 3 seconds.
はい、ここでですね、過去のプレイステーションの映像、グランツーリスモの歴史をですね、ちょっと振り返ってみたいと思います。
So now we would like to take you back in the years of the Gran Turismo franchise and look back in the series history.
これが GT1 ですね。懐かしいです。
This is GT1, reminiscent.
当時はすごくリアルでした。
Back in the days, this was real.
これがですね、もう去年のことですね、GT4 です。
Next up, GT4, just released last year on PS2.
この後に出る、PS3 の絵と比較してください。
And back to PS3.
はい、最後にですね、グランドキャニオンのコースをお見せしたいと思います。
Lastly, we'd like to show you another track from the Grand Canyon.
はい、これぐらいにしておきます。最後にですね、皆さんにお伝えしたいことがいくつかあります。まず、このバージョンはですね、将来のグランツリスモに向けてのですね、本当に通過点の一つでしかありません。
So just some last words, we would like to stress that this is only the beginning and is a passing point for the future of Gran Turismo.
もっともっと、未来のグランツリスモはクオリティの高いものになると思います。
We think the next GT will easily surpass the qualities you've seen on Gran Turismo HD.
それからですね、間もなく日本とアメリカで GT4 をベースにしたオンラインのベータテストが始まります。
Very shortly after E3, we will be conducting some beta testing based on GT4 online capabilities in Japan and in the US.
PS3 バージョンで発売する将来のグランツリスモはですね、オンラインをサポートする、グランツリスモを拡張するというよりはですね、むしろこうオンラインによってグランツリスモが爆発するというか、そういうことを狙って、作っていきたいと思います。
So together with full network capabilities moving forward, the world of GT will not expand, but will explode.
それからリリーススケジュールについて、プレイステーション2の時を思い出すとですね、グランツリスモは、プレイステーション2がローンチしてから実に1年半も皆さんをお待たせしてしまいました。
Just to touch briefly on schedules, when we look back at GT3 on PS2, the wait was roughly a year and a half after the new console was released.
次のグランツリスモはですね、前回のように待たせることなく、なるべく早い時点でですね、皆さんのもとに届けたいと、そう思っています。
This time around, we hope to deliver the next GT not too far from the launch of PS3.
期待して待っていてください。
So please look forward to it.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much, Kazunori-san, Tsubasa. Thank you very much. What an incredible presentation, an incredible example of how a great creator matched with great technology can produce magical results. Kazunori-san, I think it's also important to remember, by the way, that his team only just finished doing Tourist Trophy for PS2 a few weeks ago.So what you saw there was actually a relatively short period of time. Now, the next demonstration of a game that we're going to be revealing at E3 that I'd like to share with you is actually an interesting combination of three different things. The first is a traditional card-based battle game. Added to that is the power that you get from PlayStation 3 mixed with the amazing ability of computer vision.And here to talk about it some more is Dr. Richard Marks, the creator of iToy. So, Richard, what do we have here for today?
Phil, today we have the Eye of Judgment, and it's a game developed by our Japan studio, and I have the honor of showing it today here. And I'll just get started. You see, I place a card into the screen, onto the screen here, and a monster instantiates. And now I can actually interact with this card.
And
this is the idea is this, yeah, it can also move it around. It tracks the card in 3D. I'll move this card over here so that I have some room. Place down another card. And this will also instantiate a monster. Each card has unique identifier, so it can tell you which monster will instantiate. And now I can make this card attack the other monster. And I'll place another card here. Move this one back a little bit. Place this one in here.Wait for it to instantiate. Yeah, so. So there's all sorts of combinations you could have with all the different cards. You can imagine with 100 cards, you get millions of combinations.
Well, I think one of the combinations of cards that I have is probably the boss character card. So,
You have some special card here?
I have the special power-up card, just specially made for this demonstration. Let me put that down and see what that does for the demonstration. Hey! Now that's what I call a duck.
So So you can actually come to our booth and try out this game and actually play a game with the cards.
Great demonstration. Thank you very much, Rick.
Thank you, Phil.
So I'll be back a little bit later to share some more exciting products that we're going to be showing at E3 this year and beyond. But first of all, back to cars.
Well, we're going to have a lot more of these games to show you. But before continuing further with some of the additional PlayStation 3 software titles that we would like to share with you today, I'd like to spend a bit of time talking about what everybody refers to as the online or network strategy. And I've always stated that in the next generation of hardware, supported by the deployment of broadband infrastructure and the inclusion of a hard drive, that online and network will become like air conditioning in a car. So once upon a time, it was an aftermarket option, but today, it's a standard feature. Online and networking on PlayStation 2 that we started with the network adapter in 2002 has now grown to a service of more than 3 million plus registered users in North America alone. Online and networking for the PlayStation 3 is as essential as the air that we breathe. Consumers no longer differentiate whether content comes from online or an offline environment. The only thing that's important to them is whether the content is entertaining or not. As I mentioned before, all PlayStation 3 units will come equipped with a hard disk drive right out of the box to take full advantage of entertainment content online or offline. And one of the most differentiating aspects of the network console is the ability to use the power of constant interaction among users, not only to compete and play games, but to be able to socialize and to communicate, to create a space that really offers a sense of belonging and building loyalty. And the increasing popularity of sites such as MySpace is a prime example of this. So by offering a variety of functionalities beyond just gaming, whether it be account management, player profile, ranking, friends list, video chat, voice messaging, text messaging, and many more, our goal is to create and offer an environment that is more than just a place to play games, that is creating a virtual society or a community. And also, importantly, in keeping with our philosophy of maintaining an open platform, these basic services will be offered to PlayStation users free of charge. Additionally, as we learned with the PlayStation 2 network adapter, by its very nature, the connected console also gives us the ability to add another distribution channel, which is always changing, that users can access in bite-size or big portions anytime, anywhere, for all types of entertainment content, whether it be games, music, movies, or others. Well, what can the users expect? We're going to be offering a variety of entertainment content to the users of the PlayStation 3, as well as the PlayStation Portable. And one of the announcements that we made earlier in March in Tokyo was a new initiative that we will commence later this year, the e-distribution of PlayStation content playable on the PlayStation Portable by accessing our PSP download area. PSP users will once again be able to enjoy the PlayStation title they played through emulation technology running on the PSP. As a matter of fact, I have actually a PSP right here, actually running one of the first titles that was actually launched back in 1995 with the original PlayStation, now downloaded directly onto the memory stick duo of this PSP. So let me just hook up the audio first. Okay, make sure everybody can see. Okay, so we're navigating through the cross-media bar right now. So let me go to game and to the memory stick. Okay, there's a PlayStation icon right there. Let me hit that. So the game profile will boot up directly from the memory stick. And let's see if you can guess what the title is going to be by the way this game will actually start. As a matter of fact, this screen also brings back memories for me as well. I'm sure it does for some of you. And I'm sure you're dating yourself by saying that you remember. I don't know if you remember this particular opening. This was actually on the original PlayStation game as well when it was loading the game. Of course, I'm not a very good player even there. Game is powered by Namco. It's Ridge Racer. Ridge Racer. Remember that one? All right, so let me go right ahead. get right into the game. Oh, this brings back memories. I don't know if it's just me, but here we go. Go! All right. Whoa. Here we go. All right, well, obviously I'm not as good as Kazunori is at driving these cars here. But just to show you, since it's running on a PSP, obviously you can change the screen size just as you can with any other game or other entertainment content that's running on the PlayStation Portable. So let me just unplug this. This is another example, This is another example of how we continue to identify and also innovate ways to leverage IP investments that content creators have made over the many years, in addition to keeping our platforms as a viable business for more than 10 years. Another exciting aspect is the ability for consumers to make microtransactions to quickly add specific items in a game directly from game-specific shops. And of course, we will accommodate a variety of payment methods for all of the purchases, and we will be selling a prepaid card called the PlayStation card in various denominations, such as $50 that you see back here for purchase at our retailers. And consumers signing up for purchases through this card will be given exclusive information on various aspects of our network service. So with that said, let's bring Phil back on stage. Phil?
So, let's go shopping. I'm going to show you, first of all, a very quick look at our interface that users will get when they switch on a PlayStation 3. And this shop interface allows them to browse various contents and purchase various contents. This one in particular dedicated to Warhawk, and it's all about being able to buy additional levels or additional weapons. But it's also where you'll see a lot of the community features, a lot of the community features of saying what's cool, what's new, what's hot. And being able to purchase these items through your account whether that account is loaded up by your PlayStation card or your credit card or many other mechanisms. But the really interesting examples of the shop is when they're actually built into a game. And the game I'd like to share with you today to show that is our extremely popular SingStar franchise from Europe. And here we have on SingStar PlayStation 3 a really interesting combination of the power of a computer, the power of entertainment, and the power of the network all joining together. And SingStar really coming to life in the network era. So obviously SingStar is all about having lots of great songs, and Blu-ray disc delivers us a great storage medium for having a great deal of content on the disc, hundreds of songs being accessible, and also for the first time, HD content being accessible. And you can go and check out this video here, which has HD content on it. This is the singing interface where it measures you against the music. I'm going to save you the pain of listening to me sing, but I invite you all to E3 to try it out for yourselves. We're going to be showing both PlayStation 2 and PlayStation 3 versions of SingStar at the SCEA booth this year. We sold over 4.5 million units of this game in Europe, and it's been a huge franchise for us over there. So, what really powers SingStar on PlayStation 3, though, is the network. And this is where the game really comes to life. And what we're going to show you now is the ability to browse an online catalog of songs where you can go to the Sing Store and find the song that you want to buy and that you want to download. So we're going to browse through various options here, find the song and the video that we want to download, and I'm going to take you through the network platform purchasing mechanism. So here we have the ability to buy the song. I'm just putting it in as $0.00. We don't want to give any steer yet on our pricing strategy. And you can see how we have a wallet system and we have a spending limit. All of this is part of the parental controls that you would expect to be part of the PlayStation Network platform. And then downloading the song, and you'll see that the song is now on the hard disk drive of the PlayStation 3, and it's in your personal song selection. And then you can go straight in and check out that song. Once again, I'm going to save you the pain of listening to me singing. Here we have another HD video showing the great content that we have available to us from our partners in the music industry all around the world. Now, in addition to the ability to download content, SingStar also enables you to contribute to the community, and the sort of concept of My SingStar was something that we will be introducing on the PlayStation 3 version. This is allowing you to develop your own profile, to also find out who else is online on SingStar at any one time, but also customization, downloading new content, being able to download skins and other graphical effects to personalize your experience, but also to add your performances to the network. Using a camera, you'll be able to record and upload to your friends your other performances of your favorite songs using SingStar. We'll show you more of this over the next weeks and months, but this is a great demonstration of how SingStar and PlayStation 3 are really being powered by the network going forward. Great demonstration. Thank you very much, Paulina. So next up, a game from Japan, which is being developed by Game Republic, a company which is run by the legendary creator Yoshiki Okamoto. And here to demonstrate the game for us is Bill Rich, the executive producer of Genji 2.
Great, thanks, Phil. Genji 2 is an action game which is based on Japanese history. Being based on history, the stages of the game will also be based on famous battles which took place in ancient Japan. For example, this battle of Ichinotani, the player will have to battle against hundreds of enemy warriors. There will also be stages where there will be fighting on horseback, and stages where there will be massive sea battle sequences, which can only be made possible with the power of the PlayStation 3. The team at Game Republic has come back to us with a lot of great new features for this game, including such features as real-time weapon change and real-time character change. By incorporating this system, the player will be able to create their very own and unique devastating combo. See. But not only that, they will also be able to find new and interesting ways to defeat enemy bosses. And I'll give you an example of that. First. First, I'm gonna have to defeat this large enemy character here before I could get to the boss character. So, let me. Oops, sorry. Here's this giant enemy crab. What I'll do is use Benkei here to flip over this crab on its back. Let's see if he shows up. Oh, here it comes.
It's behind you.
He's all the way at the end of the screen, so if you'll hold on a second. Oh, here it comes. I'll switch over to Yoshitsune, hop on its stomach, and you attack its weak point for massive damage. So we'd be able to find all these new different ways of playing the game. This version that we're showing you right now, it was especially created for this event so that the enemy characters will be killed with one blow. But you'll be able to enjoy the full version at our E3 booth.
Bill, thank you very much for that fantastic demonstration. And if Okamoto-san is in the audience, please show your appreciation to him for a great game. Thank you very much, Okamoto-san. Now moving from legendary Japan to reality 21st century style. And we'd like to show you now our Formula One game for PlayStation 3, but with a couple of interesting twists. So we have everything that you would expect in a great Formula One game, all the incredible graphics, all the great physics, all the great AI, all the great animation. But you know what? There's something missing, and I tell you what that is, and that's a wing mirror. And I'm going to give you a very special demonstration of a wing mirror. So let's do a quick swap here, and thank you very much, Nino. What I have running on a PlayStation Portable here is an interactive wing mirror, which is actually being rendered in real time. And this is being synchronized directly with the PlayStation 3 to give you an accurate position looking backwards from your track. So you can position this next to your TV screen and see for yourself what is coming up behind you. This is a great example of the seamless integration between PlayStation 3 and PlayStation Portable, and that this software technology can be freely downloaded from your PlayStation 3 to your PlayStation Portable. And I hope you can see that this will add a great dimension to this game, but it will also add a huge dimension to many other games as this feature gets adopted by our game developers. So thank you very much for that demonstration, Gareth. That's great. Thank you. So now to share a game with you that was premiered for the first time just under a year ago, I'd like to introduce Tamim, the chief design ninja from Ninja Theory, the creators of Heavenly Sword. Over to you, Tamim. Gotta hurt.
Volunteers!
So I think you can see that what this game delivers on PlayStation 3 is the most phenomenal animation system linked to the AI of all the characters. And this allows us to get a really rich gameplay system, which we encourage you all to try out for yourself when you come and check out the game at E3. But let's see Tamim do some more mayhem here.
Thank you.
Tamim, thank you very much. Great demonstration. We wanted to show everything playable on tools that you see either side of the stage here to give you the maximum impact of the games that we're going to be revealing for PlayStation 3. But we also wanted to show you a quick video of some of the games that are perhaps a little bit further out. So let's run the video. So there is a glimpse of some of the future of PlayStation 3. So yeah, please, round of applause for the great work there. Some of those titles we've shared before, some of those titles are already announced, but it is my great pleasure to share with you exclusively today two brand new titles for the very first time anywhere in the world. The first one of which is from our studio in London, and let's take a look. Coming to a PlayStation 3 near you soon. Next up is a brand new game from one of our most successful studios within the Sony Computer Entertainment Worldwide Studios group. And this is a developer who, since their first game back in 1996, has shipped over 40 million units of software for the various PlayStation platforms. I'm going to let the video speak for itself. So for our final demonstration of this section of the presentation, I'd like to welcome to the stage Mr. Ted Price, the president of Insomniac. Ted, where are you? Coming in from this side. Thanks very much, Ted.
Thank you very much, Phil. Resistance: Fall of Man is a first-person shooter set in Great Britain in 1951. If this is the 1950s, that we don't know. For example, World War II never occurs in our version of history. Our history is the story of the near total destruction of mankind at the hands of an unknown species. This scourge has obliterated populations across Asia and Europe. And in the game, you take the part in the last-ditch efforts to save the last free state in Europe, England. Now, this game is intense, bleak, and brutal. Now, we showed this game a couple months ago at GDC, and when we did, we were just scratching the surface of what the PlayStation 3 could do. But since then, we've moved into full production, and we've been digging deeper and discovering what kind of muscle this machine really has. So let's check it out. So that's just a small taste of what's to come with Resistance: Fall of Man. And keep in mind that the game also has full-featured multiplayer modes, including 32-player online competition. So over the next few months, as we get closer to launch, we'll be revealing more and more of the game. But for now, come on by the Sony booth at E3, where you can play Resistance: Fall of Man. Thank you very much.
Ted, thanks very much. Great demonstration. So what an incredible game that is Resistance: Fall of Man. So that sums up our playable section. And you can see from all of the games that we have up and running on PlayStation 3 that we're really starting to push what this machine is capable of. But we have an awful long way to go. But what has powered all of these games so far is a lot of common technology and a lot of shared technology that we're moving between our studios, which allows us to achieve these results so quickly. But that's it for me. Thank you very much for your attention, and back to Kaz. Thank you.
Wow. Woo. Thank you, Phil, and your team at Worldwide Studios for being here today and sharing some truly exciting and remarkable titles for the PlayStation 3. Our first party lineup is looking pretty strong, but what about third parties? How are they making out on the PlayStation 3? Well, first, let me share with you a collection of titles under development from the third party community at large.
Tennis 3. Thank you. stranglehold.
Round of applause for our third-party partners on PlayStation 3. Now, it gives me great pleasure to introduce this company back onto our stage. They have been a staunch supporter of the PlayStation format over the years, and we are truly inspired what they have under development on PlayStation 3. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me to welcome back Electronic Arts Chairman and CEO, Larry Probst.
Thanks, Kaz, and a special thanks to Kutaragi-san and our colleagues at Sony Computer Entertainment. The special partnership between EA and Sony has never been stronger. It's a relationship built on trust, cooperation, and two generations of success. Today at EA, more than 1,000 people are exploring, experimenting, and developing games for the PlayStation 3. It's challenging, it's exhilarating, and the results, what they're creating for the PlayStation 3, is inspiring. This afternoon, we want to show you two brief demos. These are works in progress, an early look at some of the technology and innovation that will power EA Sports on the PlayStation 3. Let's start with the executive producer of NBA Live from EA Canada. Here's Kevin Wilkinson.
Thanks, Larry. The entire NBA team is excited about the early work on PlayStation 3. Let me start with a side-by-side comparison of last generation and next generation, PlayStation 2 versus PlayStation 3. Sports are about anticipation, intelligence, interacting with the ball or a teammate or both, making decisions in the blink of an eye. Now take a look at the PlayStation 2. With procedural awareness, we are creating players with personality, attitude, confidence, and style. We also know that we need to create players who move right. That's what makes foot planting so important. Watch here how the feet are anchored to the floor with each and every step. Now take a look at the PlayStation 2. Virtually sliding in place. No matter what the sport, footwork plays a huge role. So now that we have intelligent players who are fully aware of their surroundings and planting their feet correctly, we need to give them full freedom of movement. On the PlayStation 2, players moved in 45-degree angles, On the PlayStation 3, they have full 360-degree movement with body lean. They feel alive, they're more responsive, and they're in your control. But that's a video. Let's see how it's running live on the PlayStation 3. Let's step into the practice gym of NBA Live 07. Watch Tracy McGrady's footwork here, how he plants and explodes out of his turn, generating a quick first step with the ball. All right, let's see these guys in action. We've got Dwayne Wade from the Miami Heat and Tracy McGrady of the Houston Rockets. Oh, a nice fadeaway by Tracy. Dwayne showing his stuff, it's good. Okay, these guys are good. All right, guys, we're just about out of time. Let's say the best dunk wins. Oh, nice dunk. This is not a video you are watching here, folks. This is running live on the PlayStation 3. Very nice. So there it is, NBA Live bringing athletes to life on the PlayStation 3, where players look right, move right, and feel right. Next up, thank you. Next up is my colleague, George Borshikov. George is a computer graphics supervisor in our worldwide visualization group, where they do a lot of the early work on PlayStation 3. George also won an Academy Award for his pioneering technical work in film. George?
Thanks, Kevin. Hi, everybody. What I'm about to show you today is technology that will change the way you experience interactive entertainment. The best moments in sports and movies are the ones that pull you in emotionally and deliver a memorable performance or personality on the screen. For the last 2 years, our team has been building a state-of-the-art process that creates the most realistic real-time characters you've ever seen in a video game. The technology is called Playable Universal Capture, also known as UCAP. We invited Tiger Woods to be the first professional athlete to step into our UCAP studio. Tiger represents world-class athletic performance, and he has unique emotional reactions, like that signature smile we all know. So joining us today virtually is Tiger Woods. This demo is running in real time on the PlayStation 3 and will be user controlled by me.
Yes!
Now, let's take a look at how we're able to reproduce that signature smile.
Yes!
As you can tell, UCAP improves gameplay because the personalities in the game have never been more real. Now you'll be able to see what it feels like to sink a 20-footer and during the majors and force a playoff.
Oh, sweet.
Or if you miss a putt.
Where did that come from?
Or after struggling all day, you hit the perfect shot.
Finally.
Now you can also feel and see what it feels like to crush a drive on the 18th hole at Pebble Beach. So look for Tiger and Playable UCAP on the PlayStation 3.
That's what I'm talking about.
So as you can tell, this demo wasn't a movie. This was Tiger running in real time, live, on the PlayStation 3. Thanks much, and thanks to the brilliant team up in Vancouver.
Thanks, guys. Those are just two of the games in development for PlayStation 3. In the weeks and months following the launch, EA intends to support the PlayStation 3 with more than 10 titles, including Fight Night 3 from EA Chicago, Need for Speed from EA Canada, Medal of Honor Airborne from EA Los Angeles, a brand new game from EA Montreal called Army of Two, and of course from our Tiburon studio in Orlando, Madden NFL 07. I want to invite everyone to visit EA's booth at E3 and play an early build of Madden on the PS3. We're convinced this title will be one of the must-have games on the PlayStation 3. Kutaragi-san, thank you for your leadership and vision. You can count on EA's support every step of the way. Thanks.
Thank you, Larry, and all the folks at Electronic Arts for being here today. Now, we're excited to give you a sneak peek at the latest development from a company known all across the globe as a great storyteller in the role-playing game category. A company whose leading franchise, Final Fantasy, has helped define the PlayStation experience in the 1990s. Take a look at Final Fantasy XIII on PlayStation 3, which will become available in multiple versions, including Final Fantasy XIII and Final Fantasy Versus 13. Final Fantasy XIII, ladies and gentlemen. Now we're very proud and honored to be able to share this next title with you from famed game designer and creator Hideo Kojima of Konami. The video you're about to see is already running on the PlayStation 3 development system. The concept of this title is simply put, sense. So please give your attention to Metal Gear Solid 4 on PlayStation 3.
俺たちの戦争は終わった。だが、俺にはまだやらなければならないことが残っている。戦争は変わった。国家や思想のためではない。利益や民族のためでもない。金で雇われた傭兵部隊と作られた無人兵器が果てしない代理戦争を繰り返す。 命を消費する戦争は合理的な痛みのないビジネスへと変貌した。戦争は変わった。ID登録された兵士たちは ID登録された武器を持ち ID登録された兵器を使う。体内のナノマシンが彼らの能力を助長し管理する。遺伝子の制御、情報の制御、感情の制御、戦場の制御、全ては
監視され統制されているものなのです。戦争は変わった。時代は抑止から制御へと移行し、大量破壊兵器によるカタストロフは回避された。そして戦場の制御は歴史のコントロールをも可能にした。戦争は変わった。戦場が制御管理された時、戦争は普遍のものとなった。
罪を未来に残してはいけない。
世界を救えるのは君たちしかいない。
私たちは神聖フォックスハウンドよ。
全ての罰を僕らが受けるべきだ。スネーク、今度は俺が守る。
アベル殺しでイブに追放されたのはお前の方だ。
戦争は変わった。だが俺にはまだやらなければならないことが残っている。最後に課せられた罰は、俺の遺伝子ミームをこの世から抹消すること。それが俺に残された最後のミッション。世の中には語り伝えられないものがある。伝えてはいけないことがある。紡いではいけない命がある。
Metal Gear Solid 4, ladies and gentlemen. And now, it wouldn't be a proper E3 without introducing the man known in some circles as the father of the PlayStation. It gives me great pleasure to introduce to you one of our company's founders and the group CEO of Sony Computer Entertainment. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ken Kutaragi.
Hi, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. So, have you enjoyed our latest progress on PlayStation 3 title? Great. Same as you, I'm really excited to see so many great titles that are under development for PlayStation 3. Of course, PlayStation 3 is powered by the world's most powerful processor at Cell with RSX. But I have one more big thing that we have kept secret from you. Back in 1994, when we introduced our first PlayStation, controller was quite unique in shape, but everyone was amazed with its controllability in the 3D world. We are going to enhance its controllability to the next tier for the next generation system to navigate and control smoothly in the 4D world over the network. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the final PlayStation 3 controller. As you can see, the body is similar to the most popular PlayStation controllers, which attract hundreds of millions of PlayStation users worldwide. But inside this body, we have added powerful and elegant system. Phil, can I ask you to show us what it can do?
Ken, it would be a pleasure to share with everybody what this controller can do. Now, this is obviously a very familiar controller in terms of shape and size, But it's not what it looks like. It's what it does. So let's switch to the demo and clearly a little secret is waiting to be unveiled. Now, I want you to watch this very, very carefully. Look at what I'm doing. I lift up the controller and it flies. This controller has 6 degrees of freedom built into it as standard, with no external sensor required. So I can move this controller in 6 degrees of freedom using my hands as the entire input device. This standard feature controller will be packed in with every PlayStation 3. This controller allows me to really unlock the most incredible fluid movement in games and for the game controller to really become part of my own body, but be based upon our industry standard de facto controller interface, which has been enjoyed by hundreds of millions of people over the years. So let's take a look at another demonstration. This one is actually operating as the controller should operate, as wireless. And I think it's in our Sony rule book that whenever we introduce a new piece of hardware, we have to use a duck. So here is a demonstration of the duck, and you can see me moving it around, but I've also got more movement as well, where I can toss it up in the air. This is all built into the controller's X, Y, Z, and pitch, roll, and yaw lateral motion. Now, this controller, in being Bluetooth, being wireless, is actually lighter than the analog controller shipped with PlayStation 2.
So, Phil, how does it feel?
It feels incredibly intuitive, and I'm very excited not just for what this means for our game developers, but I'm so excited about what this means for the consumer and for their experience of PlayStation 3. I think it's a fantastic innovation.
Thank you. Great. So, thank you, everyone, for supporting. Thank you for supporting PlayStation, PlayStation 2, PlayStation Portable, and PlayStation 3. I'm looking forward to seeing exciting game applications and services with this controller. Thank you, everyone.
Ken, thank you very much. Truly a fantastic innovation that is really going to add to the PlayStation 3 success story. Finally, I have to make a slight confession and maybe a slight apology that we've had a sneak peek at this for a couple of weeks now, and we have been able to modify one of our games to really take advantage of this controller. And I'd like to share with you now Warhawk from Incognito. And here to demonstrate it for us is Dylan Jobe, the director and producer of Warhawk for PlayStation 3. Dylan. Great. Thank you very much, Dylan. Great demonstration.
Thank you.
Just scratching the surface of what this controller means for games. So, Dylan, before you go, share with the audience what you think this means for you as a game designer.
Well, it's incredibly exhilarating. The team and I are incredibly impressed with the sensitivity, the weight. Everything about this new controller is what we were hoping for the PlayStation 3. And it marks an interesting moment for us because it allows us to change from static control mechanics to very kinetic control mechanics. And as a developer and a gamer, I'm incredibly excited about this possibility.
Dylan, thank you very much indeed for sharing your game. That's great. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Don't you just love surprises? Isn't that the coolest thing? Back to cars.
Thank you, Ken. Thank you, Phil. So we have given you a glimpse into the world of PlayStation 3, a world that lives in high definition and transcends imagination. We have shown you that PlayStation 3 is the most advanced computer entertainment system in the world, designed for games, as well as to manage a myriad of entertainment content and network services. We introduced a new controller that seamlessly integrates innovation of free movement with the de facto industry standard game controller from PlayStation and PlayStation 2. And before we close our presentation for today, I did want to share with you some information that may have been of interest to at least some of you. Today, we're pleased to announce the global PlayStation 3 launch details. We will make PlayStation 3 available via a two configuration plan, one with a 60 gigabyte hard drive disk and the other with a 20 gigabyte hard drive. PlayStation 3 will ship in Japan on November 11th, 2006. In Japan, the 20 gigabyte PlayStation 3 will retail for 59,800 yen. And the 60 gigabyte PlayStation 3 will have an open price, which the retailers will set. In North America, the PlayStation 3 will be available at retail on November 17th, 2006. The 20 gigabyte PlayStation 3 will retail for $499 and $549 Canadian. And the 60 gigabyte PlayStation 3 for $599, $659 Canadian. PlayStation 3 will be available in Europe and Australasia on November 17th, 2006. We will sell the 20 gigabyte PlayStation 3 for €499 and the 60 gigabyte PlayStation 3 for €599, including VAT. We will be ramping up production to meet the already unprecedented demand for PlayStation 3. And today, I'm pleased to announce that we will ship 2 million PlayStation 3 units worldwide during the launch period. Another 2 million units worldwide for a total of 4 million units by December 31st, 2006. And finally, another 2 million units worldwide during the first quarter for a cumulative of 6 million units by the end of our fiscal year on March 31st, 2007. The production ramp-up on PlayStation 3 doubles the output of PlayStation 2 in the same time period. The best news is that we have the brightest the industry has to offer in joining us on this journey. You have already seen great content from Electronic Arts, Konami, Square Enix, and in the presentation, but companies like Namco Bandai Games, Ubisoft, Activision, Capcom, Koei, THQ, Take-Two, Rockstar Games, Sega of Japan, Sega of America, Pandemic Studios, and many others. You'll see familiar franchises on PlayStation 3 like Devil May Cry, Metal Gear Solid, Tekken, Resident Evil, Ridge Racer, as well as new original IP from both first and third-party companies and the SCE Worldwide Studios. PlayStation 3 is an impressive package, a complete home entertainment solution. And as I mentioned previously, at E3 this year, we have a sampling of titles for PlayStation 3 playable for the very first time. But we want you, our special guests, friends, and partners, to be the first group of people in the world to get your hands on some of the playable titles right here on this show floor. Ladies and gentlemen, a new era for Sony Computer Entertainment begins with PlayStation 3 now. Thank you very much, and have a great show.
Ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy playable PS3s in each of the towers located in the house. Thank you.
Don't hold back, cause you woke up in the morning with initiative to move, so I make it harder. Don't hold back, if you think about it, so many people do be cool and look smarter. Don't hold shouldn't even care about those noses in the air and the crooked stairs. Don't hold back, cause there's a party over here, so you might as well be here with the people care. Don't hold back, the world, you're holding back. The time has come to the world, you're holding back. The time has come to a world, you're holding back. The time has come to galvanize.
Ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy playable PS3s in each of the towers located in the house. Thank you.
Don't hold back. If you think about it too much, you may stumble, trip up, fall on your face. Don't hold back. If you think it's time you get up, rush time, back and sit up, come on, keep pace. Don't hold back. Put apprehension on the back burner, let it sit, don't even get it lit. Don't hold back. Get involved with the jam, don't be a prick. Hot chick, be a pick. Don't hold back. The world. The world, you're holding back. The time has come to a world, you're holding back. The time has come to galvanize. Come on, come on, come on. Come to
push the button.
World, the time has come to
push the button.
World, the time has come to
push the button.
World, my finger is on the button. My finger is on the button. My finger is on the button.
Push the button.